where we're going to be fly fishing for some epic fish in epic territory.
Welcome back to the show. I'm super thrilled to introduce our next guests who are going to put on an amazing event April 2nd, Children for Peace from Heart to Heart. Thank you for joining us, Dr. Al-Sharif, and the Vice President and Artist Relation, Muhammad Ali.
Thank you.
So tell us a little bit about your organization. It's just 2 years old.
Humans for Peace Institution, it's a nonprofit organization. All its members are peace lovers. They are promoting peace, love, human equality, human rights. We are standing against all kind of wars, and we are trying to help refugees around the world. We also a multicultural institution. We are trying to promote intercultural dialogues and interreligious dialogues. We have 5 chapters around the world. The main chapter here in Canada, because we believe in the role models of the Canadian multicultural societies. Anybody can join us on Facebook or on our website, which is humanspeace.org, or Facebook is Humans for Peace Institution.
Wow, that's amazing. Yeah. And what struck me as so beautiful about this event that's coming up is that you were, I don't say using children, but you brought children into the mix, whereas often when you're trying to get a cause out there, you have adults talking over here, and you've involved the children. So can you tell us a bit about what this event is about?
Children for Peace from Heart to Heart came to us by Muhammad Ali when he introduced this event for us. He thought about this idea for a long time after they arrived to Canada, and we believed in his cause, so we came together with the Ottawa Chinese Community Services to organize this event. This event's actually in 2 days, April 1st and April 2nd. April 1st, it will be at 6 p.m., the opening ceremony in the City Hall, and April 2nd, it will be from 10 a.m. until 8 p.m.
Oh, wow.
This event came to show that these Syrians, they are not just a number. They can do something. Mm-hmm. We are trying to involve the children now in the community and letting them know that this is their home and they have to do a lot to help. Mm-hmm. They are somebody in need and they can do that. Mm-hmm. So they painted a lot of paints. There are actually 40 of them.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
And all the proceeds of the sales of these paints will go to CHEO.
Okay,
that
great.
Is beautiful.
So you've linked the children from Syria with the children that are here.
That's right.
That's a very good connection. Right. And Muhammad, you were involved with this because you're an artist yourself, and you were helping the children. How was your experience in helping the children with their art?
Speak Arabic.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Please.
Okay. هي الفكرة من الأساس هي الفكرة أنه عبارة عن شكر للمجتمع الكندي وعلى الشيء اللي قدموه للأطفال.
It's a gratitude message for the Canadian societies for what they help the children and their parents to come here to Canada.
والشكر بالمرتبة الأولى للشعب الكندي العظيم اللي مسح دموع الآلاف من الأطفال السوريين.
He wants to gratitude for all the great Canadian nations for the wiping of the tears of these children.
That's amazing message. Thank you.
والشيء المهم حتى في اللوحات إذا بتشاهدوا اللوحات في تغيير يعني حتى كيف كانت بالأبيض والأسود كيف اللون الكندي هو اللي مضوي على طول كيف تغيرت الصورة.
If we will look for these paints and most of them they are in black and white and the Canadian flag it's bombing in color, so it's showing that the before and after. It's showing that how they used to live and how they use now with a hope and love.
That's a beautiful display of passion.
Yeah. Can we go through some of the paintings?
Sure. I would like to introduce this paint first. This paint's actually, the name of it's before and after. If you look at the one before, it's a girl standing in black and white. She doesn't know what's happening around her. And she sees disasters, wars, damaging houses, demolished houses. And then she looked in the future bright after she came to Canada. So It's again another message.
It's a beautiful use of color.
Yep. It is a beautiful use of color, and she's not complaining about the winter.
That's a very good point.
I'll pass this one to you.
This one is amazing.
It's I will protect you, my homeland. It shows the dark rain and how this Sarah standing there, the name of the painter is actually Sarah, and she's standing there trying to protect Canada from that dark rain coming down.
Beautiful message. You can see how the passion that's come from Muhammad into the children's artwork.
How old is Sarah?
13.
13. Great.
Okay. Beautiful.
That is wonderful. So is it, it's an auction, a live auction for all these paintings?
Yes, we will have a live auction and online auction. So even people who couldn't come, they can go to Eventbrite and look for Children for Peace. They can message us and we will send them the auction link. So even if you couldn't come, if you have no chance to come, please participate and help us to promote this project.
Great, and will the live auction start the same day as the online auction?
Yes.
Okay, perfect.
Yes, they will be in the same day.
Oh, good.
And has there been a connection with the children, the artists, I should say, has there been a connection with the artists with the children at CHEO? Are you working together with CHEO in that aspect?
Actually, this is the second project we are bringing. Mm-hmm. We will go all together with the children to visit CHEO.
Oh,
we will handle the check to CHEO. But extra to that, we have a surprise for the children over there. So it's only not the only check.
Okay.
We also have a surprise. I would like also to talk that we are trying to organize more events with the Syrian children to involve them in the community, to bring another message of volunteering and donation and fundraising to help others. So there will be some surprises coming soon.
That's great. And how can the community help support this event? I mean, obviously we have some great artwork to go visit and to purchase, but how else can the community support this event and the overall organization?
The most important is to support us, to come and see these pictures, to promote the message of peace. In Humans for Peace, Humans for Peace Institution, we believe in one message, that humans' power is stronger than people in power.
Right. Wow.
So people's power is stronger than people in power. So we can come together, we can do anything if we would like to do that.
Yeah, I can see that.
Nothing can stop us.
You know what, this just shows it right here, because these are young children. Muhammad, thank you so much
for
bringing this beauty here.
Thank
and thank you for explaining.
Thank you, guys.
Everyone at home should definitely take part in this online auction or go live to Ottawa City Hall. And don't go away, because we have another hot ticket in town, and that's the Ottawa Parent and Child Expo.